Hello, welcome to this video. It's Leonard here from LITECOIN.com, and in today's video tutorial, I'm going to walk you step by step on how to bind your PrimeBot account with your Binance account via API. So if you are new to this channel, if this is your first time of seeing my videos and you like video about making money online, about crypto trading and investing, then consider subscribing to be the first to be notified each time videos like this are published on this channel. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. That way you encourage me to create more free content like this. So for the PrimeBot account, it is assumed that you already have an account with PrimeBot. If you don't have one already, then there will be a link in the video description to sign up for an account to, you know, start trading with this bot. And you can equally join us on the WhatsApp group. The link will equally be in the video description. So here we are on the PrimeBot. Once you log into your account, the first thing you want to do in order to bind it with your Binance account is to go to where it says, is there, you click on where it says select now, where you have this platform, or you select API. So these are the two options you have to actually go to the API page. So if I click on select now, it will take me to this binding page. And if I go back and click on API here again at the top, it will still bring me to this page. So here, when you are on this page, it is not left for you to say, okay, I want to start by trading with my Huobi account. That means you need to have an account, a verified account with Huobi, and you need to have a verified account with Binance as well in order to be able to use these two exchanges. So, but in this case, we have a verified Binance account. So we'll go ahead and click on buy now on the Binance tab. So you click on buy now, and it will bring up this page you are seeing here. So we are going to get an access key, which is the API key, to paste on the access column key, and then we'll get a secret key from what the API we are going to create as well to paste on the secret key. So all we just need to do is to go back to Binance. Let me just go ahead and open up my Binance app. So once you open up your Binance app, what you will need to do, for instance, if this is your first time of using Binance and you are not having the kind of interface that I'm having right here, the first thing you will need to do to be able to have an interface like this is click on this head icon here at the top left hand side where you are seeing the arrow. Click on that head icon. So once I go ahead and click on that head icon, by default, this Binance Lite, let me use the arrow, by default on your own account, Binance Lite will be toggled on. So you want to go ahead and toggle this off in order to have the interface that I'm having to be able to follow up. So if your Binance interface or application on your phone is not like mine, then you need to do that to be able to do that. So once you're able to have this interface just like this, the next thing you need to do is to come in here to where it says more. Let me use the arrow to give you that direction. So you click on more here. So all I'm just going to do is to go ahead and click on more. And when I click on more, it opens up your apps like this. So you want to scroll down here and go to where it says API management. This is what you need. So you go ahead and click on API management. So I'll go ahead and click on that. Once you click on the API management, the API creation page will open up. So the first thing we want to do here is to go to where it says label API key to proceed. So you go ahead and label your API key. So in this case, I'm going to say this is a PrimeBot API key. API. Then add key to it. You can name this whatsoever you want, actually. You can name it whatsoever you want. So this is what I prefer to name mine. So I'll go ahead and click on create API. And when I click on create API, based on your security level, whatever you use to, you know, protect your account. In my own case, I use both phone verification, email verification, and then the Google authenticator code. So I'll go ahead and send code, get code for the phone, and then get code for the email. So those code has been sent successfully. So I'll go ahead and open up my email to get the code from it. All right, that of the SMS has entered, so I just go ahead and click on copy, and once I copy that, I'll paste it on the SMS column. Then the next thing is to go and get the email verification code. So I'll go ahead and open up my email, and this is the code right here. So I'll go ahead and open this, and, you know, just copy the code. Once I copy the code, I want to go back to Binance. on the email column here, I'll just click and hold, and then the paste option will come up. I'll paste this, and then the next thing is to get the authenticator code. Once I open up the authenticator app, my screen will go blank, so you don't really need to see what is going on. So I just go ahead and open that up, and I'll go ahead and copy Binance code. Just click and hold. Once it's copied, I'll come back to the Binance account and then click and hold here again and paste that code. So this is all I need, and then the next thing is to go ahead and click on submit down here. So I just go ahead and submit. An API key created successfully. So this is our API key. Once this API key is created, the next thing you will need to do, or the first thing you want to do before you copy the key, is to click on where it says edit. But first, to expand this, I'll click on the arrow down here, this arrow somewhere here. So go ahead and click on that arrow. So I'll go ahead and click on it, and it will open up this like this. Then the next thing I want to do is to click on edit, because I'll need to give this API key privilege, the privilege to trade on my behalf. That is the instruction I'm giving this API key, or the bot, via this API key. So once I click on edit, I'll scroll down here to where it says, you see the options down here. Down here you have enable reading, and then you have the enable spot and margin trading is not checked. As you can see right here, it is not checked. This is it, it's not checked. So this is why we want to edit this. So we are going to enable that, and you can leave every other thing as default. Basically, what we are concerned with is to enable spot and margin trading. So you go ahead and check that. Once you check this, you want to go ahead and click on and scroll up here. You can leave every other thing as default. This is just our concern, because what this bot does for you is to do spot trading for you, buying low and selling high. Features are not enabled, so you don't really need. So you go ahead and scroll up here and click on save. Once you click on save, they will say you'll get this error that permission expired. Just go ahead and click on OK, and you will be asked to verify your account. So I just go ahead and open up my authenticator code again and copy the code and paste there for this to be able to go through. So I'll go ahead and copy that of Binance again. So once I copy it, I'll come back to Binance, then paste that code here. Click and hold to paste, and that will automatically be verified. As you can see, it has been edited. So if you come in here, it has automatically been saved. Once it tells you permission expired, just go ahead and click OK, verify your account that you are the one. So you see that automatically that has been checked. The spot and margin trading here is checked actually. So you can see there that it's checked. Let me use the arrow so that you can see that very well. It is checked. I did not enable withdrawal because I don't want the bot to withdraw from my account. This is just what I'm concerned with. This is enable spot and margin trading. That's all. And then the next thing we want to do before we close is, don't use your back button to actually go back. So that, because if you go back one step, then the secret key will no longer be visible. So you want to first and foremost on the Binance app, copy the secret key. So I'll go ahead and click and hold on the secret key. Once it's highlighted this way, I'll go ahead and copy it. And then the next thing I want to do is to go back to my PrimeBot, and where it says secret key somewhere here, this is the secret key. This is where we are going to paste that key. So I just go ahead and click and hold. You see the paste option, and then paste the secret key. And the next thing I want to do is come back to Binance again, where it says API key. Just click on where this copy icon is. Just click on this copy icon. Once you click on it, it will automatically copy the API key for you. So you go ahead and copy that. Then I'll come back to PrimeBot again, and then click on the access key, click and hold, and then copy, just paste that. Once you paste that, you want to go ahead and check, I have agreed this option here. So you go ahead and check that, make sure it is checked. And after that, the next thing is to click on submit. And this will automatically be submitted, and this will be saved on your account. So I'll just go ahead and click on submit. And once I click on submit, you see that the bound is successful. So it has been bounded successfully. I'll go ahead and click on confirm. And then after that, all you just need to do is use the arrow at the top tier, at the top left hand side there, to go back to the home page. So I just use the arrow to go back, and use the arrow one more time again to go back to the home page. Right now we can start trading. So if I come in here to the other page, you now see that this has been successfully binded to my Binance account and I can start using it. And if you have funds on your Binance account, the funds will be reflecting here, USDT, whatever USDT you have, the balance of the USDT you have will be reflecting here. If you've just binded it and you are not seeing any USDT reflecting, then just click on any of this coin you want to trade, go to the setting. I have a step-by-step guide on which trading settings you need to do on the video on the channel, so go ahead and see that video and see how you can carry out your trade on the PrimeBot account. So basically that is all I have to show you. You create your API, bind it with your platform, with your board, and then you can go ahead and start trading with it. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you are new to this channel to be the first to be notified. And when you subscribe, hit the notification bell to be the first to be notified each time videos like this are published. So that is it for this video, and I will see you guys in the next video.